Welcome to Q&A, Social Security Disability Today. This program is brought to you by the Reeves Law Firm, representing you and your Social Security and disability needs. If you have a problem or questions regarding Social Security and disability, call attorney Anthony Reeves. Here's your host, attorney Anthony Reeves.
Okay, everybody. How to ask, well, first before I go any further, for those of you who are wondering why I'm looking like McGruff the Crime Dog, as you probably know, November is No Shave November, No Shave November, so for men's health awareness. So from now to probably the end of the month and probably the first couple of days in December, I will not be shaving, so I'll be looking like this McGruff the Crime Dog thing. Let it go. All right. How to ask a question to a disability attorney. People, you would be surprised the number of emails, instant messages, and even phone calls that I get from people who have questions. And it's amazing because the messages that I get usually it starts with, "Hey, Attorney Reeves, this is such and such. I got a quick question for you. Could you please call me back?" Okay, first and foremost, there is no such thing as a quick question for attorneys, because attorneys don't give quick answers, because there's very few things in the law that can be answered quickly. But for those of you who have called me, reached out to me, or even reached out to another attorney and can't quite understand why either one, you're not getting a response back, even though I try my best to call everybody back when I can, or two, when you're talking to the attorney, they seem to be a little gruff when they're talking to you. I'm going to share a few little things from the inside minds of a disability attorney. Woo! Scary place. But this also can be applied to other attorneys as well, so bear with me. First, attorneys are business people. So the reality is they are always looking at things from the light of how they can make money. It's no different from a farmer or a mechanic or a doctor. Even though their trade is a particular thing, everything they do is designed to generate funds because they have people to pay, they've got bills to pay, they've got a life to support. So, when you call a disability attorney, the attorney is assessing two things. Is this a way I can make money or not? From the standpoint of a disability attorney, I'm always tickled when people lead off the bat with a question to me and they say, first of all, I'm on disability. Now, let me pause you right there. I make money off of helping people get disability benefits. So guess what happens if you call me and the first thing out your mouth is, I'm on disability benefits. Think about it. You're basically telling me, and you're not calling me because you're going under review. You're just calling me because of something else. So what does that tell you? You're basically telling me, and this is what you don't know, and I don't want you, and some people are gonna be like, God, I'm never gonna call him again. I just want you to understand what goes in the mind when you call people. Because sometimes I'll have people say, I've called other attorneys and they haven't been very responsive. First thing out your mouth is you say, I am on disability benefits. What you basically told me as a disability attorney is I can make no money off of you, which means you're calling me for free advice, which means for every minute that I'm on the phone with you is a minute away from a case that I could be making money on. Now, some people will say, man, that's really rough. And I'll be honest, most of you know I do these videos. I've had a few people post me, well, Attorney Reeves is promoting his firm as well and so forth, so it's not totally free. I'm like, dude, I have done over 300 videos. I've had people, I always tell people, for those people who say, let's be real, do I do this to benefit and promote my firm? Absolutely. This is what I do for a living. But let me also be blunt when I say, I have spent 300 videos on here. It's countless number, hundreds of hours where people have sent me questions and I have specifically answered their questions on these videos so they can have something to go back and utilize for later. So yeah, so at the same instance, it is for the benefit, but I give a lot of information away for free, not only for the people who ask me the questions, but for those people who have those same questions who come and they find these videos. And I appreciate the positive feedback, but I always have to put that in mind. But when you call, that's a little bit different standpoint, because when you call someone, you're basically taking them away from what they're doing to make money, to answer your question, and they can't make any money off of you. Now, some people, I've had a few great people who say, Attorney Reeves, I know you, your time is money, and I would be more than happy to pay you a consultation fee. Usually I don't. And I've done it a couple times where I've said, sure. And I'll send them an invoice. I've sent them an invoice for the consultation fee. And of course I need to find out what location with Social Security so I can find out how to get approval for it. And guess what happened? Person didn't pay the fee. So then what you do is you say, okay, you got two choices. Do I answer the question and say, don't worry about the fee, or do I tell them pay me up front? Most people don't have the money, so I don't mind answering the questions. But here's what you got to keep in mind. When you're calling for a case and right out the gate, the first thing out of your mouth is, I am on disability benefits. You're telling the person, I can't make any money off of you, but I want you to give me your advice for free. I want you to take time away from your clients and take time away from your ability to make money and give me free advice. And some of you are like, dang, Attorney Reeves, that's gruff. I just need you to know what goes into the mindset of somebody. If you call someone and you can't quite figure out why they seem to be a little stank, that might have a little something to do with it. Now, I look at it a little differently. My philosophy is that if you care enough to take the time to call me, I'm hoping you care enough that if I give you a response that you like, that you'll tell others who may be able to utilize my services. And I'll be honest, I've had quite a few times where that has actually happened, where somebody says, hey, I got your contact information because somebody used to watch your videos and they said I should use you. I looked at your videos. I want to use you. Let's make it happen. So we got over that first hump. All right. Well, here's the second hump. Ask the question first. Let the representative tell you what more information they need. What happens is people work in reverse. They're thinking, whatever I ask them, they're going to ask me for information. So I might as well just give them the information now and then ask the question at the end. Let me tell you why that's a wrong logic. Two reasons. One, you don't know exactly what that representative needs to know from you. So you know what you're doing? You're dumping. You're dumping a lot of stuff that they may not need to know. So that's the first thing. You don't know what they need. Secondly, when you dump, go back to my original thing. If they're willing to provide you feedback for free on their own time and you're dumping, that means, you know how long, how many, we've all had that friend of ours who's long-winded, and I ain't gonna lie, I'm like that for a lot of my friends. I'm the long-winded one. They give you this long story before they finally get to the point when they could have just started with the point. Attorneys are the same way. So if you got a story that's going to take you 10 minutes to get out, you're annoying that attorney, because that means the longer you have to go through all that, the more they have to sift through everything to figure out what they need to answer your question, and you've now taken time away from their bottom line. Now, I've had people get annoyed, and they'll say, well, if you let me just go through my story, because this is where it really gets nasty. Remember, a seasoned representative or attorney, they know what they need. And let me tell you the first thing they don't need. They don't need you dumping everything. Because what's happened is you have decided in your mind what you believe is relevant to tell them. And you know what you believe is relevant? Everything. They're telling you that specifically to answer your question, they only need specific relevant facts. And once they get those facts, they can determine if they need more. Dumping does nothing but waste their time and annoys them. You're thinking, oh, there's a garbage attorney. He don't know what he's doing because he needed the whole picture. Now listen to how you say this. You're going to someone asking for their legal advice, okay, and you are trying to make the decision as to what they need. Think about that. It's like you going to your doctor and telling your doctor what you believe he needs to or she needs to know about your medical condition. Now, the doctor's like, I need to know. That's not what I need. I need this. Well, he needs to know because all this plays together. Well, I went to medical school. I've been practicing for so many years. I'm telling you, that's not relevant, not for what I need to know. And then what happens a lot of times is that when you're giving all that information, if that information comes out later, then the person's like, see, I could have told you that stuff. I told you at the very beginning. And then I always tell people, yeah, but see, this is the problem. You're telling it in an order that makes logical sense to you in terms of asking your question. But it doesn't make logical sense to me as the receiver of the question, because I need to know if that is something I need to know right now. Let me give you a good example. I had a woman call me a long time ago. because she said that she can't figure out why Social Security, and they didn't go through all her medical records, and this is just, and I said, stop. Who is this for, you or somebody else? My child. Why did they find it? Well, no, you need to understand about all this medical condition, and you need to understand. And she was going off, and so I just sat there very quietly, and then I stopped her, and I said, let me ask you something. Did they deny you? Well, I said that at the very beginning. Why? Well, they said I made too much money. Stop right there. Can't help you. She was so angry, and then finally I stopped her and I said, let me explain why I'm saying this. They technically denied you because you made too much money. So it doesn't matter anything about the medical evidence because you never get to the medical because the assets were too much. In other words, all that noise you just gave me about the medicals, about how they overlooked all this, is irrelevant because you made too much money. Am I saying it's not important? No, I'm not saying the medicals are not important. Well, I'm saying that I could have answered your question in 1 minute if you would have just told me and answered my question early on about the fact that there was money that they denied you because of the assets. But you didn't want to do that. You wanted to get your story out. And ultimately, at the end of the day, I've been doing this long enough that I know when people come to me, they want to get their story out. They really are, you know, and this is the one thing I know. When they come to me, they want somebody who's going to listen to the whole story. And I get that. And under most of the circumstances when I'm talking to people, I end up getting the whole story anyway. But I need you to understand this. When you're going before a representative and you're asking for general information, just ask the question and let them determine whether or not they need